I'm interested to hear you say the president acknowledges we can't fix, even if it's just private or public, right, whichever way, that we can't fix everything in the Middle East. An area that, of the world that you know, again, as much about or more about than anybody is Israel.
Yeah.
Right? Do you think he views the situation in Israel as not fixable by us and thinks that we maybe should hit the brakes a little bit, pump the brakes on what we're doing there?
No, he thinks that peace is possible, but he thinks peace is not available at the moment.
What do you mean?
I mean that peace, of course, is possible as a goal, and it's a man-made problem, like all the problems that you deal with. So there is a fix somewhere, but it's not. You know, he's a ruthless pragmatist in the sense that, you know, he looks at his calendar, he looks at when he's stopping to be president, right, and says, I can do X, Y, and Z in this period of time, and I can't get this other thing done. So he pushes that off
did
the
he
table.
Not, did he not think that this was an important enough strategic interest of ours from the very beginning to
well,
have started
I'll tell
earlier?
You, I'll tell you this, though. Yeah. He thought it was very important at the beginning, and what the Arab Spring proved, and then the rise of ISIS proved, is that it turns out that the Israeli-Palestinian dispute is not actually that important. It's right now, it's the fourth or fifth most important conflict going on
in the
Middle East. It's way down the list.
Yeah.
He believed, coming into office, that you solve this, you solve a lot of the problems in the Middle East. Now he realizes that what the Arabs were focused on the whole time was not Israel. Right. They were focused on their own crappy leadership and their own religious disputes and their own sort of working through some of the basic endemic problems of their society.
Is Netanyahu the problem? If Netanyahu had not been the leader of Israel during so much of the Obama presidency, could more have been done?
Right. It was a tragic misalignment of essentially a Republican Israeli prime minister and a liberal Democratic American president. That said, let me answer the way I think of it. I think Netanyahu was certainly a problem. Abbas was certainly a problem. The Arab states' unwillingness to actually put their money where their mouth is was a problem. Rising religious fundamentalism, particularly in the Muslim world, but also in Israel,
right,
a big problem. All of these things were surmountable, but separately, but together, I think it created a situation in which, and by the way, the Obama administration made some serious mistakes early on in the way it managed this problem, both on the Israeli side and the Palestinian side.
Avoidable mistakes.
If mistakes born of inexperience and not listening to all, you remember, there's 30 years of people who made mistakes.
Right.
So, you know, one of the first things you think you would do if you're trying to go make Middle East peace is go to all the people who tried, from Henry Kissinger up, and say, so why didn't it work?
What would you have done differently?
And here's what I think I want to do, and tell me if I'm right or tell me if I'm wrong. But they came in, you know, any new president comes in gangbusters, right?
Yeah.
And they're like, we're going to do the opposite of what Bush did.
Right.
I mean, that was there, you know, like, he did this, we're going to do that.